While it is the last one. Arise and the choir sings the procession song. Feel free to let us rejoice. Join me to very warmly welcome our main celebrant, His Excellency Archbishop Augustine Kasuja. You are most welcome, the people receive. Let us very, very warmly welcome Reverend Father Andrew Hodge, Third Assistant of the Superior General. You are most welcome. A very, very warm welcome, Reverend Father Cyprian Binang, Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, and other provincial councils. You are most welcome. A very warm welcome, my dear priests, religious and superiors of other congregations that are here. Thank you for your coming. Baba, welcome very much. Thank you very much for coming and giving us and finally, welcome the Bagole of the final vows. You are most welcome. At this moment, let me invite our main celebrant, His Excellency Archbishop Augustine Kasuja, to lead us in this Mass. Your Excellency.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brethren, let us unite our prayers today to pray for the religious who are making their professions today, and to pray for the whole congregation of the Holy Cross, for their mission not only here in Uganda, but all over the world. I have personally met missionaries of the Holy Cross in many other countries. I began in Bangladesh, where they had very big schools, important schools, even though in a Muslim context, but schools which have desired not to convert the Muslims, but to give a witness of Jesus Christ to those who need it. I meet them also in other countries, here also in Kenya, in Bugembe, from the moment they arrived from Port Oto to Kenya. And I'm happy to preside over this Mass with these missionaries. And I ask them also to pray for me. I pray for them. Brethren, as we prepare ourselves for this celebration, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have faithfully sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my faults, through my most grievous faults.
Thank you.
that the grace of baptism should flourish with your servants, so that they may strive to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son. Grant, we pray, that constantly seeking that evangelical perfection, they may add to the holiness of your church and increase our apostolic zeal. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
We'll have two readings, and the first reading will be taken from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 61, verse 1 to 3. By Sister Catherine Makova, CSC. Our second reading will be from the letter of St. Paul, the Philippians, chapter 3, verse 7 to 14, and taken by Sister Patience Masika, CSC. Let us listen to the word of God.
The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord, and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion the dead instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a distressed spirit. They will be called oaks of justice, planted by the Lord to show his glory. The word of the Lord.
After this, Jesus appointed 72 others, whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for the harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals. Greet no one on the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' And if a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. I say, stay in the same house, eat and drink what's offered to you. For the labor serves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter, and they welcome you, eat what is said before you. Cure the sick in that town, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.' Whatever town you enter, and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, 'The dust of your town that clings on our feet, even that was shake off against you, yet no peace. The kingdom of God is at hand. I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Sodom that day than for that town." The gospel of the Lord.
I greet the assistants here in the congregation of the Holy Cross who traveled all the way from Rome. I greet the regional the delegate, Father Binata. I wish to greet and congratulate the Holy Cross congregation for having prepared since a long time and presented to the church today these young men Gabriel, I particularly address myself to those candidates for the profession today. Once you heard in a dream someone calling you, come and follow me. I shall make you fishers of men. Or whom shall we send? Today, that dream will become a reality. As you pronounce your perpetual vows of obedience, purity, and chastity in the congregation of the Holy Cross. You know very well that at the age of about 30 or 33, when Christ began his public ministry, in the temple of his own village, Nazareth, he took up the reading from the book of Isaiah, which we have heard today. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to bring good news to the afflicted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, those who are prisoners of the evil one, to comfort those who mourn, and give them the oil of gladness instead of mourning. After the reading, Jesus closed the book, sat down, and said in his comment, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." By these words, the Jews understood that Christ, the Anointed One, the son of Mary and Joseph, in Nazareth, would become a powerful among them, capable of proclaiming the good news of salvation and to bring freedom to his people tormented by sin and death. My dear brothers, what was once a dream will today become a reality. You will pronounce with courage and grace the religious profession of your commitment for life. Hear, I am God, send me. Or in the words of Our Lady, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let what you have said be done to me. My dear brethren, gathered here today, parents and friends, we are here to pray for these candidates, to thank God who called you, who called them, even before they were born. But we must be very grateful to the parents of these young men, and to everyone who has taken them by the hand and accompanied them in one way or another on the way to reach this moment of the final profession as believers. Let us also clap for the parents. Dear brothers, you are not called to live in competition with one another, or in mutual hatred, but as brothers who consider the other superior to you. I love that brother when the religious profess they call themselves brothers, even the priests. The religious women, they call themselves sisters. This is important. Lord, if you call yourself brothers, resemble that brother of Assisi, the brother Francis of Assisi, who prayed, Lord, make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is sadness, joy. Oh, divine master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console others, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love, for it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned. That means that as consecrated people, we should not let created things or material things keep us away from God and from one another. Saint Augustine, my patron saint, whose history I have celebrated just 2 days ago, lived by that principle of brotherhood. And even wrote a model rule of community life, which has now inspired almost all the consecrated people. When I worked in North Africa, where he was born and was a bishop, he used to meditate on that rule of community life, even though I am not a religious belonging to a religious congregation, but that idea of St. Augustine as to that community life inspired me a lot and continues to inspire me. Dear brothers, the Holy Cross congregation is a missionary congregation. Embrace in full and be proud of the charism of the Holy Cross. Recently, when I had some visitors from abroad, I went to visit our shrine in Mangongo of the Martyrs. After visiting the place where Charles Manga was martyred, went with them to visit the shrine of the Anglican Church. We were very well received. A young man took us around, explained everything in the museum on the martyrdom of our martyrs. And at the end, he told us, please let us say the prayer. He made this a spontaneous prayer. And at the end, I intoned one of the hymns of the Ugandan martyrs. We said to our Father together, and I made the sign of the cross at the end. But the gentleman who took us around did not make the sign of the cross. And I was surprised to see, are you Christian? Do you make the sign of the cross? What I meant by that is the cross. And that I have lived when I worked in Muslim countries. You go around and around, you are seeing the Son of God, revealed in the world. The first saint of the Americas and Philippines, St. Rose of Lima, speaking of the meaning and the implications of the cross, said that the cross, he put our words, is the only true stairway to paradise. And without the cross, men can find no road to climb to heaven. We expect that each brother who makes his temporal or perpetual commitment should be disposed and ready to go anywhere where the superiors decide to send you. In other words, should be ready and disposed to take up the cross. In the gospel we have heard today, describing the mission of the seven disciples sent out by Jesus, symbolizing that the message of Christ is destined to all nations and not only to the Israelites, the Lord Jesus sends them out not as individuals, but two by two, in a spirit of solidarity and in collaboration with others. He makes it clear to them that the harvest is abundant, but the workers are few. That was the case 2,000 years ago, and until today we can say the same. The workers are few. What they must do first, and above all, is to pray that the master of the harvest takes care of his mission of the divine message of joy and healing. Vocations are a gift of God and a fruit of prayer. To persevere in one's vocation, one needs to pray constantly. Other means are there, but what is most essential is to pray constantly for the fidelity to your vocation. In the exercise of that mission, Jesus advises to assume and embrace a spirit of poverty and detachment. Today, the world is very attractive. Today, the world has many ideologies. In this gospel, we hear that when one receives any hospitality, Jesus advises to remain satisfied with the food and the drink offered, and not to move from house to house, just looking for more comfort. In his personal witness, St. Paul testifies, we have had these words in the second letter, in the letter of the Philippians, St. Paul testifies that whatever gain I had, I counted as loss for the sake of Christ. For his sake, I have suffered the loss of all things and count them as
that powerful communion, especially for our brothers who are preparing themselves in this moment to confess their thoughts and find His Excellency, and Bishop of Sweden. Now the moment has come for us, as we continue to pray, to witness to the profession of five perpetual vows of our brothers. And this moment has a number of stages, about four, which I would like to just share with you. There will be the calling of the candidates, where the applications director has come and take care of that, call their names. They have been prepared and to how to respond. So even if you are called by that name and you're not a member of this candidacy, please do not respond on their behalf. Thank you so much. At the second stage will be the examination. Our brothers will be examined on the three evangelical councils: poverty, celibacy, and obedience by our superior, provincial superior. When that is done, again, I remind you, even if you are leaving them or you are renewing them, do not respond on their behalf. It is them that are responsible for that. When that is done, you shall all be invited to kneel and pray for them through the litany of all the saints, as the choir will be guiding us through that. The second last stage will be the presentation of the insignia, symbols of our identity as members of the Congregation of Holy Cross. And then finally, the admission that will be done by the provincial. So like I said, we have three roles during this celebration: to pray, to witness, and then finally to celebrate. In this moment, as people gathered, I'll invite you to pray as you also witness. So while the choir leads us in the hymn to the Holy Spirit, I will be, this is prepared, I will invite the provincial superior in front of the second member, testimony about each one of them. Please be attentive.
Let those who are to make profession of each vows please rise. Douglas has an nightmare of the congregation in politics.
Present.
Emmanuel Isarini of the Congregation of Holy Cross.
Present.
Abel Jenny Moody's, a friend of ours over the last 5 years in Macaulay Formation House of Nairobi, and having fulfilled the required formative pillars of human, spiritual, intellectual, apostolic, community, and the bar life, we
assignment while in school at Tangaza University. time when people finish the Angaza, they also did another Mukapas right here at Bogembe in Kachinja. While doing this, we was a procurement manager working with the sisters. He worked tirelessly.
Innocent Abuelisa of the Congregation of Holy Cross.
Present.
talk about elements. Elements comes to Holy Cross from the Port of Catholic Diocese, from Jesus Parish in Jengede District in Western Uganda. Generally, elements comes across as a shy and a quiet man, but he's a clear-headed and a brilliant person. In one-to-one dialogue, he has a piercing gaze directed at you that speaks about his inner strength and self-confidence. Elements demonstrates deep and internalized faith in the way he leads and encourages himself. Something to note here, he is the son of a very devout and dedicated retired catechist, and maybe that explains his personality. Throughout his formation time, Elements has been generous, supportive of others in the community. He has been an excellent student who is able to interpret well that knowledge into his life as a religious and a seminarian of the Congregation of Holy Cross. He carries himself with integrity and strives to witness to the values, spirituality, charisma of the Congregation of Holy Cross. He's hospitable, understanding, compassionate, and able to create serenity where there might be confusion and dissension. To many of his fellow seminarians, he has been a beacon of hope and strength. Hope that continues. So our provincial Father Cyprian, we the formation staff commend Elements for his willingness to bring the best of him to the Congregation of Holy Cross. We commend him for his readiness and courage to venture into unknown spaces of his inner life that has given birth to a very committed, articulate, devout religious. We therefore feel that Hermes is ready to make his final commitment in the religious life in the Congregation of Holy Cross and in the Church.
Even in volatile situations.
God, you deserve some others as a member of the congregation of Holy Cross. So, Father Cyprian, our provision, we the formation staff commend Innocent for his emotional maturity, spiritual desire, and his aptitude for community life. We commend him for his giftedness and creativity that he brings with him to both ministry and in the community life. We commend his willingness to be a true witness and a moral compass for Christian values. We therefore feel that Innocent is ready to make his final commitment in religious life in the congregation of Holy Cross.
Of the congregation of Holy Cross.
Present.
From Bobayana University in Rome. to God. The formations have found toward him ready, and we commend him to you to accept this vows into the congregation of Holy Cross.
Patrick Tugume of the Congregation of Holy Cross.
Present. A versatile person and a
person who is gifted in many ways. He's a very athletic person also, self-driven, has a good sense of humor, computer literate, and a jovial person. Spiritually, he's a prayerful person and committed to living the spirituality of the congregation of Holy Cross and its mission. Academically, he did very well in his studies. He majored in education with computer and geography as teaching subjects. He is a committed person to the profession that he has chosen. Oftentimes, Patrick will come and ask me, "Brother, what does it mean to be a brother?" And you talk about it. So Patrick is a community. He is a community minded person, and he did his best to help his fellow conference in their needs. He is a good addition to our congregation. Last year, he did his pastoral assignment in our parish in Bungay with the Holy Cross Family and Ministries. And currently, he is the head teacher of our schools in Nairobi. The formation staff found him ready to get this final commitment. And we asked you, Provincial Superior, to accept his vows into the congregation of Holy Cross.
I'm here again to present goodness for Vincent Valibudene. There is a saying, they don't make them like that anymore. But well, in Vincent, we have one of those. He's made like that. His name expresses his presence. Named Valibudene, Vincent is a person at peace, and a person of peace. And he extends that peace to others as well. With Vincent around, you will know safety and peace. The time information has witnessed Vincent moving deeper into a personal understanding, a spiritual transformation from a simple, passionate young man to a deeply virtuous person committed to the charism and the spirituality of Holy Cross. He exemplified true virtues and personal qualities of what our formation program focuses into. Being a smart student and a community person at heart, Vincent brought out a remarkable sense of an integrated Holy Cross religious. Vincent is an explosive preacher. Anyone will have a tough time controlling Vincent's passion for the word of God. He sometimes makes you wonder why, how many times you are limited to just a few minutes. As he stands here today, Vincent exemplifies a true son of Father Moreau and a strong hand on the plow for the work ahead. His presence gives many of us courage to a confident future, even a future retirement, because we know what things will be all right when he's around. And so, Father Provincial, we, the folks at Macaulay Formation House in Nairobi, we feel proud again to present Vincent Balikudele on this 30th day of August, the year 2023, for his perpetual profession of vows in the Congregation of Holy Cross. And we pray for him that God may continue to fulfill in his heart and in his life what God himself has.
My brothers, what you ask of God's church and of the congregation of Holy Cross? My brothers and sisters gathered here in prayer, God has called these men, our brothers, to follow Christ as religious of Holy Cross. In our joy, let us express our thanks for this sign of God's love. Thank you, God. My brothers, in baptism, you have already died to sin and have been consecrated to God's service. Are you resolved to commit yourselves forever to single-hearted intimacy with God, to trusting dependence upon God, and willing surrender to God?
I am resolved.
Are you resolved in consecrated celibacy to love with a freedom, oneness, and availability that can be recognized as a sign of the kingdom?
I am resolved.
Are you resolved in consecrated obedience to join with our brothers in community and with the whole church in search for God's will?
I am resolved.
Are you resolved to give over your whole life in generous service to all people, to serve them out of your own faith, that the Lord has loved us and died for us, and risen for us, and that he offers us a share in his life, a life more powerful and enduring than any sin or death?
I am so.
May Almighty God grant you the grace to fulfill what you resolve through Christ.
After they are resolved, we shall now prepare ourselves to pray for them through the intercession of all the saints. All the rest are kindly, we shall kneel while they who have resolved prostrate fully and summon themselves to God for that intercession as the choir will lead us in that moment. us with a prayer, an invitation, and the choir will proceed.
My brothers and sisters, let us pray. Through the intercession of Mary and all the saints, that God, the Almighty, may bless and strengthen his servants who have been called to follow Christ in the religious life.
Christ of mercy, Christ of mercy.
Holy Spirit, purify your servants from all sin, and make them burn with the fervor of divine love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I, United Douglas, Godfrey CSC, kneel in the presence of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and my Lord, in the assembly of his church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and before you, Reverend Father Cyprian Rinaga CSC, Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, to profess my dedication and my vows. I believe that I have been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life's work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen me and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Douglas, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God, who has begun this good work in you, bring it to completion.
Isabel de Manassesi, near the presence of Jesus Christ, the Son of God and my Lord, in the assembly of this church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and before you, Reverend Father Cyprian Binakas Yesi, Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, to profess my dedication and my vows, I believe that I have been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life's work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Emmanuel, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who has begun this work in you bring it completion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am Sibwe Hermes, CSC, stand in the presence of Jesus Christ, the Son of God and my Lord, in the assembly of His Church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and before you, Reverend Father Cyprian Binakas, CSC, the Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, profess my dedication and my vows. I believe that I have been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life's work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen and protect him to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hermes, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who began this good work in you bring it to completion.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I, our innocent CSC, kneel in the presence of Jesus Christ, the Son of God and the Lord, in the assembly of His church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and for you, Reverend Father Cyprian Donaka, CSC, the Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, profess my dedication and vows. I believe that I've been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life to work in the service of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vow of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Innocent, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who began this good work in you bring it to completion.
I call upon Sister Mildred Omondi and Honorable Dr. Okello to be my witnesses. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I, Joachim Ganda, CSC, kneel the presence of God and my Lord, in the assembly of His church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and for you, Reverend Father Cyprian Donaka, CSC, Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, to profess my dedication and my vows. I believe that I have been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life's work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment, strengthen and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Joachim, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who began this good work in you bring it to completion.
I call upon my God, Abatia, and Father Arsenio to be my witnesses.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, Holy Spirit.
I, Martin Kule, CSC, stand in the presence of Jesus Christ, the Son of God and my Lord, in the assembly of His Church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and before you, Reverend Father, Dr. Cyprian Nanka, CSC, Provincial Superior of the Province of East Africa, to profess my dedication and my vows. I believe that I have been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my life's work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the constitutions of the congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Martin, in the name of the Church and of the congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who began this good work in you bring it to completion.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I, Brother Patrick Tugume, CSC, stand in the presence of God, my Lord, in the assembly of his church, amid the congregation of Holy Cross, and before you, Reverend Father Cyprian Binaka CSC, Provincial Superior, Province of East Africa, to profess my dedication and my vows. I believe that I've been called by the Father and led by the Spirit to offer my life and my next work in the service of the Lord for the needs of the Church and the world. Therefore, I make to God forever the vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the constitutions of the Congregation of Holy Cross. May the God who allows and invites me to make this commitment strengthen and protect me to be faithful to it. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Brother Patrick Tugumi, in the name of the Church and of the Congregation of Holy Cross, I accept your vows. May God who began this work in you bring it to completion.
Thank you.
Douglas, receive this image of the crucified. He saved the world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps and you'll come to share the glory of his resurrection. Emmanuel, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the whole world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Hermes, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share the glory of his resurrection. Innocent, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the whole world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Joachim, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the whole world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Martin, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Vincent, receive the image of the crucified. He saved the world by his cross and invites you to share in his mission of service to all his people. Follow in his footsteps, and you'll come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Brother Marvin, receive the image of Saint Joseph, the patron and guardian of our congregation. Through his example and prayers,
may you come to serve the Lord Jesus Christ and so come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Remember, my brother, that you have crucified the world with Jesus Christ, and that you can reach heaven only by walking on the royal road of the cross. Brother Patrick, receive the image of Saint Joseph, the patron and guardian of our congregation. Through his example and prayers, may you come to serve the Lord Jesus Christ and so come to share in the glory of his resurrection. Remember, my brother, that you are crucified to the world with Jesus Christ, and that you can reach heaven only by walking on the royal road of the cross.
So at this moment, I would like to invite all the Holy Cross readers, priests and brothers and sisters to rise up, and the provincial will lead us in prayer as we pray for our brothers who have just professed their vows. In this time, we shall raise the right hand and we pray for them. Please arise. Only the Holy Cross religious priests, brothers and sisters. Watawa, washirika na msalaba mtakatifu tu, mtainua mikono yenu, yakume tuweze kuombea.
Thank God for the gift that you have.
the Krapo, Muche, Ubapulise, Kularino, Kalazu, Kama, Yarawa, Nekuna, Kubalino, Waya, wherever you go. While you are sitting there, when you laugh, you can shout, you can move it, you can see the thing about them. Thank you so much.
Shall turn and look at the people. Thank you.
salvation, always and everywhere, to give you his hands. Lord, your Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, he is the unblemished flower whose sprung from the root of the Virgin and declared the pure of heart blessed. Issued by his will of life, his everlasting and world.
Christ, by the Son and work of the Holy Spirit.
gospel, you give life to all things and make them well. And you never cease to gather everybody you have served, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously made holy, these gifts you have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family we have summoned before you. In your compassion,
through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy kingdom come, thy kingdom come.
7.
Apostle Union Prayer. We have a few other business to attend to, some introductions, other sessions, and a few speeches, then our celebration of the Apostle. So at this moment, shall we arise and pray?
Let us pray to the Lord. Having received with reverence the divine mysteries, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, to inflame with the fire of the Holy Spirit these your servants, bound to you now by an act of sacred offering, and to admit them forever to the company of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. God inspires all holy desires and brings them to fulfillment. May God's grace always keep you, our brothers, faithful in the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ and the evangelical life in all his cross.
Amen.
May God keep you single-hearted in your consecration, consecrated servants, generous in your poverty, and whole-hearted in your obedience.
Amen.
May God always keep you steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and enduring in love.
Thank you. Let me now take this chance to introduce to you some few people already. They have been mentioned to you. But our ministers, we have the third general assistant of the congregation of Holy Cross, Father Drew Gorwich, CSC. You are very welcome and raise and wave to the people. You already know the provincial superior, Father Cyprian Binaka, CSC, who received the vows of our brothers here. Let me also introduce to you one important person in our congregation, the vocations director, Father Mwenya Lawrence, CSC, through whom these have also responded to the call. Father, you will raise the people. He will wave to you when you meet outside there. But we are very grateful to them. Let me also introduce the Holy Cross religious priests present. Will you rise and please wave to the people? Thank you. I'd like to introduce to you also Holy Cross religious brothers who are here. Please rise and wave to the people. We also have Holy Cross sisters. If you are present, please wave to the people. Thank you so much. I request if you are any priest from any other part of the country, if you are around, you can wave to the people, priests from other parts of the country. Other religious who are present, if you are present, please wave to the people and we can also welcome you. The rest of us, we thank you for your presence. Christians from Kenya, Holy Cross Parish, Dandora, Makoto Wao. Christians from Holy the Queen of Peace Parish, Timoroa, Elbereth. Wakristo kutoka Tanzania, St. Anthony of Padua Parish, Kasaka Mwanza. Wakristo kutoka St. Brian Parish, Kitete. Karibuni sana. Wakristo kutoka St. Great Heart Parish, Sabatini. Na Wakristo kutoka Musoma, Mugiani wetu, Mtegi. Karibuni nyote. Uganda, we have Tuna, our priests who are St. Adolf, Holy Cross Parish, Kanyama Chope. Elina, Kabatagira, we have Bija. St. Louis Parish, Chabusazi. We have Bruno, we have Bija. St. Denis, St. Kwao Parish, Konge.
Very sure.
ceremony, and then you will have Mother Superior of Male Reproductive Sisters on behalf of the Association of Religious in Uganda. When she's done, the Provincial Superior of the Congregation of the First Province of East Africa will follow, and then I'll let you know what's next. Thank you very much. Very short.
Thank you, Father, for sending me short. I've called my brothers here. Please, you can look at the people so that they can feel the joy of our Lord is good. And all the time. Friends, today is a very important day in our lives. What we celebrate today is not a work which began on the 7th of July 2014, but a work which started even before we are born. For that, God has been very gracious in our lives. Please join me to give a very well-deserved hand clap of God. Indeed, He has been very gracious. He has kept us safe, and we are here smiling, celebrating the most desired day of our lives. To our families, I want to mention very kind words to you. Thank you for teaching us how to pray. Thank you for teaching us how to love. It is the same love which has now helped us to commit our souls today perpetually to the Lord. And we believe it is the same love we shall radiate to the people we shall be ministering to, our new spiritual family. Thank you so much. Okay. I also wish to mention this, that when you miss us at some point, and you see us less, when the demands of our ministries, the demands of our missionary work don't permit us to see you always, to attend birthday parties, to attend baby showers. Please understand, we are very much with you in spirit. People are praying for us. Thank you again, and we love you so much. To our other family, Holy Cross, we want to thank you so much, our brothers and sisters. Some of us joined as boys, and now today we stand as professed, perpetually religious men, no longer boys. Of course, some of us were elder, but others were more boys than the others. But God, we thank you so much for journeying with us and nurturing us spiritually, intellectually, in community life, in our religious vows. And now we are so proud that with your support, we have reached this very important day of our lives. We begin by thanking the fishermen. Of course, we have just been three. We started with Father Temalopo. He handed us over to Father Luke. And of course, now Father Lawrence Mwenya, who invited us for the examination here. Thank you so much, our vocation directors. We also would like to thank our formators, beginning from every house, the novitiate, and now the post-novitiate formation house in Nairobi. You, our elder brothers, have been inspiration to us. You challenged us to growth. You journeyed with us, and you were patient with us when we were stubborn. You are also patient with us when we grew. And that patience created a space of growth in our hearts. So we want to thank you so much.
beginning with Father Ronnie, who is not here, Brother Emma, and Father Michael, Matthew, those people join with us in every house. And then officiate, we are blessed to have Father Tom Smith, Brother Emma, those people made a foundation of prayer in our lives, and I think today it is more evident that it is a prayer which has made us rich this day. So I invite you to clap for those very important people in our lives. In the proficient, we are blessed to have several. So we are not formed by a small group of people. We had Father Silva Mabwani, we had Father Kaketo, we had Brother Kofi Mesa, CSC. Stand up for recognition. We also had Father Jenga, who is not here, Father David, and now Father Katendi. Brother John Flood, we can't also forget him. Thank you so much, our dear brothers, for joining with us. We have also worked in very many ministries, and we have met our final professed brothers who have been our house directors. Others have been our on-site supervisors. Some of us have been lucky to work with sisters. So we want to thank you all for journeying with us, for guiding us, and for training us to be zealous religious of the congregation of Holy Ghost and the Church. Thank you so much. We don't want to forget our brothers in formation, with whom we shared the bread, with whom we enjoyed the body camp, volleyball. I know some are already maybe in class this time, they may not. They didn't attend here, but virtually some may have a chance to see this. I want to thank you, brothers. And to us, we want to act as an inspiration. Of course, if all of us here can make it, it means it is possible. So we want to encourage you and to also mention that we are eagerly waiting for you to work with you in the active ministries. And today, to all of you who have made this day a very colorful one, beginning with the social committee headed by Father Semaganda, for your tireless work making this a stress-free event for us as the Mangole, so that we can be addressed. We worked on the logistics of accommodation, the logistics of transport, and I've had you mention a good lunch. So I want to thank you so much, Father, and your committee for that. And to this Mass, which has seen us become finally professed, we want to thank our main celebrant, His Excellency the Archbishop Kasuja Augustine. Thank you so much, Your Excellency, for having us in this Mass and guiding us in prayer to commit ourselves. And to you, our provincial and your council, thank you so much for approving us for final vows, and also the general council for following and approving us too. Thank you so much for finding us worthy through your prayer for discernment, and also for your support. You have always accorded to us during our formation, the academics, and whatever support you give to us. Thank you so much, Father, for that. We don't want to forget the choir. I was seated with my brother Hermes. He mentioned that he was so happy when he had said Hermes being well elaborated. Thank you so much for your angelic voices, which made us feel the angelic presence. To you, my dear brothers, indeed, this day is a very important day in our lives. An and I'm confident we always know that every finish line is the start of a new race. And for us, we know this is just the start. And we confirm that it is the Lord calling us. May God bless us all and bless you so much for coming and for loving us. Thank you so much.
God is good, and all the time. I'd like to add my sentiments of gratitude, His Excellency, the Apostle Ignatio Agustin Basidia. Thank you so much for accepting to design your values to the Eucharist, in which our prayers have made the accomplishment. Thank you.
leaders in the church. Thank you so much. May God bless you. In the evening, when we were welcoming you last evening, I talked to our parents, the parents of Brother Mario, and I said, this is what God has desired, and they too love it. That was very, very strong. Thank you so much. We love what God has loved. So may you be blessed as you follow Christ. Just for 1 minute, I'd like to give an opportunity to Father Andrew to greet you, representing us behind you.
Yes,
sir. You're probably hungry like myself. So just on behalf of over 1,300 Holy Cross brothers and priests around the world, I extend our congratulations, our love, our fraternal support to our brothers who professed their final vows today. Let us continue walking together in the light of the Lord. Thank you.
Father Archbishop, thank you so much for your blessings and allowing us to take a few minutes. Father Speranza, thank you so much for your precious words and presenting your experience. May God bless you all. Your Excellence, we have a token of appreciation. Thank you so much. May God bless you.
I have been for the principal words here. See you ever see you. Anyway, at this moment, we shall not have pictures and such a photography here, but we'll proceed outside when the priests are done with the altar. We'll proceed outside and receive different categories of photographs. Otherwise, thank you so much and God bless you. Other programs will be communicated when we are out there. Thank you so much. Choir. Oh,